All right, hello. In this skill, we're going to determine a graph from an inequality, or the other way around, we're going to determine what inequality matches a graph. But before I get into the problems, let's just talk a little bit about inequalities and the signs and everything. So think about this. We all know on a number line that if I have a 1 here and I want to put a 4 on the number line, it's going to be to the right. So there's a 1, there's the 4, and we know that 1 is less than 4. That's our inequality sign for less than, right? But if I write the 4 first and the 1 second, you got to reverse the sign. Again, people say flip the sign, but if I use my fingers here, if I flip that, it's the same thing. So really, we're reversing it. We're reversing it, so 4 is greater than 1. So you just got to be aware of what you're talking about and what part of the number line you're talking about. So now let's apply that to variables. If I have, let's say I have a 5 here, okay? I'm gonna circle that. Right now I have x equals 5. That's the only point that works, it's 5 right on that point, okay? Now, if I want all the numbers that are greater than 5, I want all the numbers that are greater than 5, I want all the numbers that are this way, and shade the arrow too, but I don't want the 5. So I'd have to erase the point for 5, and I just have an empty circle, okay? If I wanted to include the 5, I'd put equal sign and I have to shade that in. So it's good review there, right? But what if the 5, let's put the variable on the other side here. If I put the variable on the other side, what sign would I use? Well, look up here. All the numbers that are shaded, all these numbers that are shaded are greater than 5. But if 5 is written first, 5 is less than all those numbers. And it also is equal to. So again, you have to watch where you put the variable. And that determines, you know, what's shaded and how you read it. Okay? Now going along with, well, let's just stop there. Let's go now to some of these problems in GMM. So here it says to choose the inequality for this graph. Now this thicker bar represents 0. So you just got to recognize that. That's where the 0 is. And notice that it's shaded. It's a thick pink circle and everything to the right. So all the numbers that are shaded represent the x. And all those numbers are greater than or equal to 0. So I'm looking for that on my list and I don't see it. But if I reverse and switch the sides here, I put x to the right, 0 is less than or equal to x. And that one I do see, which is right here. So make sure you're checking out, you know, what's being shaded. The shaded numbers represent the variable. The variable represents those shaded numbers, any of those numbers. And they all have to be greater than or equal to 0. So then be aware, if 0 is listed first, 0 has to be less than or equal to all those numbers. So let's tap in there, and we'll hit the green check mark. Done. Erase my marks. So in this problem, we want all the numbers shaded that are greater than negative 3. So 0 is here. So 1, 2, 3. So here's negative 3. And notice there's no equal sign, it's just greater than. So I know it can't be this one, anything that is with a complete circle shaded in. So it's either the second or the third one, B or C. And we want all the numbers that are greater than negative 3. So it would be these right here. Tap on that. So for the next one, write the inequality. This time we're supposed to write the inequality. You're supposed to use an X. And the X is all the numbers that are shaded. All these numbers that are shaded, all these down here, we'll call them X. They're all less then this number right here, what's that number there? Well, here's 0, so negative 1, negative 2, that'd be negative 2. And it's not, the circle's not shaded in, so it's just a less than sign. So if I type in x and then the less than's on your keyboard, if it was a less than or equal to, notice a less than or equal to, it'd be here, but we don't need that. We don't want the equal sign. And then I want a negative 2, type that in. I think we got it. Oh, need to change my cursor. Tap it. It worked. Again, if you can make a mistake, you got to go back and look at your logic and think, where did I miss out? But so far, we're doing okay. And the next one, we're given the inequality. We want all the numbers shaded that are less than or equal to negative 4. So I got to find negative 4. Here's 0. So 1, 2, 3, 4. It's right there. And it could be a solid circle because it's less than or equal to. So I'm going to tap on the menu button. I want to make sure it's a solid circle. And I go over to that negative 4 and I tap right on it. And I want everything that is less than or equal. I have the equal to negative 4, so I just tap to the left. All the numbers that are less than negative 4. See how we did? Do a couple more yet. Now this one, choose the graph that goes with this here. Now I like when my variable's first. It says negative 1 is less than x. Negative 1 is less than all the numbers that are shaded. So that you could, that might make sense to you. But I like to write my variable first. So I'm thinking I want all the numbers. And that's the x. All those numbers can be the x. I need to reverse that sign so it becomes greater than. So I want all the numbers that are greater than negative 1. So negative 1, here's 0. Here are my zeros. So negative 1 would be right here. I want all the numbers that are greater than that, but not equal to. So it's got to be this one here. Just take a look at the other ones, make sure, and voila. And we'll finish up with this sixth problem. All the numbers less than or equal to 0. So it includes equal to, so I change to my solid dot. I want 0, and I want all the numbers that are less. So it could be equal to or it could be less. Less is to the left. Boom. All right. Good luck with those.